So as we were just saying, antibiotic resistance doesn't provide evidence for evolution. The germs are actually going in the opposite direction that evolution requires. It does seem kind of strange, though. I mean, the germs seem to have gained power over the antibiotic.
But it's because the mutations that cause the resistance are in some form or another defects. The so-called supergerms are not really super at all. They're actually wimpy compared to their close cousins.
Yeah, that's right. Dr. Whelan recalls, when I was finally discharged from hospital, I still had a strain of supergerm colonizing my body. Nothing had been able to get rid of it. After months in hospital, however, I was told that all I had to do on going home was to get outdoors a lot, occasionally even roll around in the dirt, and wait. In less than 2 weeks of this advice, the supergerms were gone. Why? The reason is that supergerms are actually defective in other ways, as explained. Therefore, when they are forced to compete with the ordinary bacteria, which normally thrive on our skin, they do not have a chance. They thrive in hospital because all the antibiotics and antiseptics being used there keep wiping out the ordinary bacteria, which would normally outcompete, wipe out, and otherwise keep in check these super wimps.
Let's go roll in the dirt.
Yeah.
So they're weaker, and the reason they cause so much death and misery in hospitals is because the normal bacteria have been eliminated in the clean hospital environment. Mm. So the weaker but resistant bacteria are able to thrive. Also, environments that tend to select such resistant germs, like intensive care units, are precisely the places where there will be critically injured people, physically weakened, and often with open wounds.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so there are four conclusions we can draw. Number one, supergerms are actually not super at all. They are generally less hardy and less fit to survive outside of the special conditions in hospitals anyway.
Two, there are many instances in which germs become resistant by simple selection of resistance which already existed, including that imported from other bacteria.
Mm-hmm. And three, where a mutational defect causes resistance, their survival advantage is always caused by a loss of information. In no case is there any evidence of an information-adding type of, you know, uphill change.
Four, supergerms give no evidence to sustain the claim that living things evolved from simple to complex by adding information progressively over millions of years.